was late.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Firstly, we thank Allah and we congratulate every one of us for being part of the Muslims that put us the first Jumu'ah during this year Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our supplications, and may He Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us among those who witness the end of Ramadan and many more Ramadan in life, inshallah. We have few announcements. Number one, our request for sponsorship is still open for iftar and sahur of the last 10 of Ramadan. Iftar, we started already since yesterday, and alhamdulillah, we have few sponsorships, and still, we are still expecting more. We can check the notice board so to know the available nights so that we can sponsor and be part of this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us all. Jazakumullah khairan. Secondly, we have special lectures or public lectures in all Sundays of Ramadan. I mean, four Sundays, starting from this one on the 20th of this month, where we will be meeting Associate Professor Luqman Zakaria from IIUM. Inshallah, the following one will be another lecturer, inshallah. So the time is 5 p.m. immediately after Salat al-Asr until Iftar. We'll be here together listening to the Sheikh, and there will be chance for question and answer, inshallah. After that, we make Iftar together, Salat al-Maghrib and Taraweeh as well. Finally, so I think I'll stop here first. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Ashhadu
نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers in Islam, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having granted us life so that we reach this Ramadan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from each and every one of us all of our good deeds during this month. This month and this first Jumu'ah, this is an opportunity for us to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is an opportunity for us to look back at the Ramadan that passed and to ask ourselves whether we did enough, whether we achieved the goals that we had set ourselves. And if the answer to that question is no, I became distracted. I became involved with things that took me away from the remembrance of Allah. Now is the time, now today is the day to recommit ourselves to the goals that we set for ourselves in the last Ramadan and to make that intention to do much more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us these opportunities, these seasons if we were to call them that, these opportunities for us to draw closer. Every year, every day, every week, there's an opportunity. And we only have to reach out and grab those opportunities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. We all know the virtues of this month. We all know what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did in this month. And it is my dua for myself and for you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this month. What I want to talk to you about is not necessarily the virtues of the month. It is not to talk to you about the purpose of fasting. But what I would like to point out, because these are things that have been on my mind, and that has been, what will I be and how will I be when I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What will I have to show for the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questions me on the day of judgment and my feet do not move until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks me, one of those reoccurring, issues that I grapple with is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask me about my knowledge and whether I acted upon it. This will be something, or this is something, that affects me deeply. And I want you to think about that as well. I want you to ponder every single week in the month of Ramadan, not only in Jumu'ah, but these Sunday lectures that our esteemed Imam has spoken about. Your lecturers, your Imams will remind you. They will talk to you about the ayat of fasting and the Quran. They will talk to you about the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the virtues of fasting and the virtues of salah and qiyam in this month. The virtues of, inviting people to iftar, etc., etc. But it is not enough, my dear brothers, that we are constantly reminded by the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We speak about the early Muslims and their accomplishments. We read that many of them would finish a reading of the Quran every single day. And we are amazed at that. And it motivates us. But as soon as we leave the venue, the masjid, that motivation seems to wane. So what we need to do more than anything else is to remind ourselves of the opportunity and to remind ourselves of the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us and give us if we were to implement that knowledge that we are gaining on a daily and weekly basis. So this is my dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْتَنْظُرُ
ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, those of you who possess iman, does the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not say that the one who fasts the month of Ramadan, imanan, he believes in Allah, he believes that Allah has obligated this month of fasting upon him, he believes in the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised him, wahtisaban, so therefore he works and he does it hoping in that reward. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing us here. This taqwa that we must have and for the which the month of Ramadan and the fasting of Ramadan has been legislated is that each and every one of us achieves it. This is an awareness and a consciousness and a fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that should affect our behavior, should affect our deeds, the way that we conduct ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fear Allah, have taqwa of Allah, place between yourselves and the punishment of Allah a barrier. But then he says, let every single soul see, take into consideration, look at what they have presented for the future, for tomorrow. Meaning for the day of judgment. What have we done, my dear brothers, that will earn us the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What are we doing right now? Are we taking this into account? Are we holding ourselves accountable? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. The more we think about our deeds, the more we think about death and the year after, this should motivate us. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month of Ramadan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us of those that perceive this the way that it is meant to be perceived, who understand it as it is meant to be understood. That we know that we are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is commanding us that we pay attention to what we are doing and what we are preparing for tomorrow. The month of Ramadan is here. Every single morning we wake up and we have our suhoor, alhamdulillah. Why do we do that? We do that so that we may follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that we listen to his command. تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السُّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. Have your suhoor because in it is blessing. And so therefore we get up. What motivates you? Only that hadith. That's why you get up and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our suhoor. When you have iftar, why do you break your fast so hastily? You break your fast so hastily so that it's because you are following the commands of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I want you to pay attention to your eagerness, your willingness to follow the sunnah. Look at how eager you are. You set your alarms. Subhanallah, we even set multiple alarms in the month of Ramadan. We even tell friends and family to give us a call to make sure that we have woken up for suhoor. Is it not so? Look how eager we are to follow the sunnah. Let that eagerness not wane and diminish after the month. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that in everything you do, you want to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only for suhoor and iftar, not only for qiyamul layl or taraweeh, but in everything that you do. Because we will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it is this eagerness to follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that will be the difference between success and failure. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا. And he repeats the command to have taqwa. Because this month is all about that. Why is it that when we are alone in the month of Ramadan, with no one to watch us and to keep an eye on us, we continue to fast, even though it would be so easy to eat and drink, without anyone knowing what we were doing. That consciousness, that fear that we have of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is meant to be with us every single day. Is meant to be with us whether we are in private or in public, whether we are with family or at work, whether we are in Malaysia or outside of Malaysia. But that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us so many places in the Quran. But then he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is intimately aware of every single thing that we do. The fact that when you are alone and you don't break your fast, that feeling that you have, that needs to be with you all of the time. Why? Because you are afraid that people will find you, that they will see you, and they will think less of you, they will judge you, and they will criticize you. No. Because you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. Isn't this the definition of ihsan? to perfect our worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him as if we see Him. And if we do not see Him, then we know that He sees us. Imagine you could be like this all the time. Every time you have a conversation with your wife or your husband or with your children, whether you are at work, and we see that in our times, wallahi, it is heartening. It is amazing. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us. What is amazing? To see how eager people are in the month of Ramadan. Eager to fast. Even our children. Eager. Proud of themselves. And we make dua that that eagerness can be something that we take with us even after the month of Ramadan. After the month of Ramadan, after Eid al-Fitr, another season will come. Another opportunity will arrive. The first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And for those of you that are performing Hajj this year, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you a Hajj mabrur. Before I forget, I want you to take into consideration the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he said, وَرَمَضَانِ إِلَى رَمَضَانِ كَفَّارَةٌ لِمَا بَيْنَهُمَا, that one Ramadan to the next is a kafara, an expiation for whatever happened to between it. إِذَا اجْتُنِبَتِ الْكَبَائِرِ, if the major sins were avoided. So now, if we look at that, here's an opportunity. Let me explain what I mean. Let us focus on this month. Let us do as much as we can. Let us exhaust ourselves like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did, especially those last 10 days. Then let us commit ourselves to being the best Muslims we can possibly be. And when the next Ramadan comes and we fast that month like this or better, all of our sins that we committed between those two Ramadans will be forgiven, as long as we have avoided the major sins. Before a person, and think about this, a person who can avoid eating and drinking in the month of Ramadan for the sake of Allah, can that person not give up all the other sins and everything else that Allah has prohibited? And the answer to that question is a definite yes. You can definitely do it. If you can give up what you need to survive for the sake of Allah, why can you not give up lying and backbiting and stealing and every other thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited? It should come easier to you. It should be natural. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us that. The ayah continues and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. And do not be like those people who forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They ignored Allah. They turned their backs on Him. And let us be honest with ourselves. A few days ago, we did not have the eagerness that we have now. We did not have the commitment that we had now. We did not have the willingness to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we now possess at this very moment. So we forgot ourselves. We forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isn't it amazing that in the month of Ramadan, you see that people rush to the shelves of the masjid to pick up a mushaf, a copy of the Quran, and they read. You see people waiting in the waiting rooms and they have out a copy of the Quran or on their phones. You see people flock to the masjids to pray. So they remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But let us not be like those who forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at other times of the year. So that Allah causes us to forget ourselves. We forget our duties to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah gives a grave warning for people who do that. He says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. Those are the people that have rebelled and turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are defiantly disobedient. Let us not become that. Let us make dua on this day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us of the salihun, the mu'minun, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us of the sabiqun, those who are the forerunners in doing good. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day that He makes us of these people who will turn to Him, have taqwa of Him, and will remember Him at all times. The month of Ramadan, my dear brothers, is also a month of the Quran. So let me remind you of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger says in the Quran. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّي. He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the messenger says, my Lord Allah, indeed my people have taken the Quran, they've boycotted it, they've turned away from it, it's mahjura, it's been abandoned. Are we those people? Is the ayah talking about the Quraysh of Makkah and the Arabs that were enemies of Islam? Because if it is, then you and I must be the furthest from these people. The Quran should not be boycotted in our lives or abandoned, but rather it should be in front of us every single day. It should not be something that we turn our backs on. Do we not know that the Prophet ﷺ said that for every ayah that you read is 10 good deeds? I do not say that alif lam mim is a harf, a letter, but alif is a letter, and lam is a letter, and mim is a letter. Some of you might be saying, but you know, Tariq, I'm not very good at reading the Quran. My recitation is weak. I don't know how. I know I struggle. Did the Prophet ﷺ not say that the one who reads the Quran fluently and expertly, that he is with the noble angels, the ambassadors, and the one who reads it, listen carefully, the one who reads the Quran and he struggles with it, he stutters, he finds it difficult, for him is two rewards. The reward of reading and the reward of perseverance, even though he is struggling. So even though you struggle, that should not stop you from picking up a mushaf and reading to the best of your ability. Wallahi, Malaysia and this part of Malaysia specifically, because we have all of these amazing Islamic universities and colleges, we are blessed with people who are qualified, men and women. And this is the perfect month then for you to perfect your recitation of the Quran. Find a scholar, find a muqri, someone who reads the Quran with perfection, and go and read to them and perfect your recitation, because not only will you be improving, but for every harf that you read, you will get 10 good deeds, and if you are struggling, your reward will be double. So let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala see that we have taken the Quran, not abandoned it, but that we have turned towards it wholeheartedly, with full concentration and willingness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to multiply our rewards in this month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us of the forgiveness of our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us closer to Him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us success in the year after. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. Wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikri al-hakim. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا لا ينفد أفضل ما ينبغي أن يحمد وصلى الله وسلم على أفضل المصطفين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تعبد. One of the things that I alluded to in the previous khutbah was the issue of istiqama, steadfastness, the ability to remain steadfast, committed to pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to take the month of Ramadan as a period, but rather for the month of Ramadan to be a period, not the period, a period in our lives where we strive to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we strive to earn His reward, to earn His pleasure. Istiqama means that whatever we have been doing in the month of Ramadan continues after this month. Make that intention, be committed to doing that, so that we do not see the masajid empty after Eid al-Fitr. That we do not see that there are people have turned away from the book of Allah and the copies of the Quran gathered dust for another year. Let us have istiqama, my dear brothers. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us that istiqama. Because one of the most beloved deeds, if not the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Inna ahabba al-a'mali ila Allahi adwamuha wa in qalla. The most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those that those deeds which are done consistently, even if they are small. So commit yourself to doing something. Commit yourself to reading a page of the Quran, a half a page of the Quran, or more or less. Spending 10 ringgit in charity every day, more or less. But be consistent. Because consistency is what is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us not be like those people. You know those people who go to the gym and who diet? Those people who work out for a week and then the gym membership ends. We know, I know the analogy might be, you know, out of place. But let us not be like those people. We all, you know what that feels like. And I'm talking about something that is so much more important. Istiqama. So that when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have accumulated a massive good deeds that you and I will be proud of on that day when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, 2 weeks ago, my wife gave birth to a baby girl. Alhamdulillah, it's my first girl. And one of the things that I think about not only my new baby girl, but my children and your children, is that what kind of example are we going to set for them? And so the month of Ramadan is that perfect opportunity for each and every one of us to show our children what the month of Ramadan means. It's a perfect opportunity to show them how the Muslim is supposed to be, so that when we leave this world and our children continue to live after us, they remember that time when my father took me to Taraweeh, when my mother and father read the Quran, when my parents invited people for iftar. They see that, they see the charity, they see the salah, the sadaqah, the zakah, they see all of these things. Now is an opportunity to establish that amazing example that will benefit your children, but will also benefit you in the year after. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our children the coolness of our eyes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them all those that grow up in the worship of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encouraged us to increase our salawat upon him on this day. So I say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidul majid, wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidul majid. Allahumma izzal Islam wa ansur al muslimin. Allahumma izzal Islam wa ansur al muslimin. Allahumma izzal Islam wa ansur al muslimin. Allahumma ansur ikhwanana fi Filistin. Allahumma ansurhum fi al-Iraq wa fi Syria wa fi Afghanistan wa fi Burma wa fi kulli makan ya rabb al alamin. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا ومن ذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.
Sufufakum, straighten your lines, fill all the gaps, stand shoulder to shoulder with your heels in a straight line. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنب
عنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. هل أتاك حديث الخاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله